when you're in that sort of like environment, your entire personality completely changes because you have nothing else to follow, because nothing else matters except from this fairy. And so she kept saying to me, like, oh, you know, this is like completely changed who you are, this is like destroying you. And you know, I think it was like almost like worse for her sometimes, because she had to live with me and I was only talking about QAnon. That's the only thing I talk about.
We're sick and tired of being abused. We're sick and tired of...
You know, it makes you really paranoid because you think that everyone's against you. Like, the system's against you, the government's against you. And I was constantly preparing for like the absolute worst scenario. Like, a new world order was going to happen.
What we're finding is in the wake of the pandemic that conspiracy beliefs may have gone mainstream and they're no longer confined to the fringes. So around half the population isn't thinking in terms of conspiracy beliefs at all, but around a quarter are entertaining such thoughts. Another quarter are consistently thinking in terms of conspiracy beliefs. Around 1 in 10 people seem to have a very high rate of endorsement of conspiracy beliefs.
Rumours and false information during a pandemic are nothing new. We've seen that for centuries. It's a really natural human impulse. What technology has done is it's enabled them to spread far more quickly and far more internationally in a way that is fairly unprecedented. A rumour can begin in Italy one day and it can be across multiple continents a few days later, as we have seen happen several times.
If it went for, you know, social media and the algorithm system, I think I wouldn't have fallen like that deep into the rabbit hole.